and upon those in the tombs bestowing life.
In Jesus' praise,
Lord, have mercy.
To thee, O Lord.
as long as I live, I will sing praises to my God while I have being. Put not your trust in princes, in sons of men, in whom there is no salvation. When his breath departs, he returns to his earth. On that very day his plans perish. The Lord will reign forever. My God, O Zion, to all generations. Now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Only begotten Son and immortal Word of God, who for our salvation is filled to be incarnate of the Holy Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, who without change did become man and was crucified. O Christ our God, trampling down death by death, who art one of the Holy Trinity, glorified with the Father and the Holy Spirit,
is your reward in heaven.
Prayers of the Theotokos, O Holy Lord.
Constantine and his mother Helen, review the precious cross, the weapon of the faithful against their enemies. For our sakes it has been shown to be a great song. Creator and Master of all, crying to all in the midst of the feast of the Lord, come and draw the water of immortality. We fall before thee and faithfully cry, grant us thy mercies, for thou art the fountain of our life. Lord, have mercy. O Lord, save the pious.
Yes, ma'am. Lord, and abundant in power.
His understanding is beyond measure.
Great is our Lord, and abundant in
power.
His understanding is proclamation has gone out into all the earth, and their words to the ends of the
I will deliver thee from the people and from the Gentiles, to whom and from the power of Satan unto God, that they might receive forgiveness of sins, and an abundance among those sanctified by faith that is in me. Therefore, King Agrippa, I was not disobedient to the heavenly vision, but showed first unto them at Damascus and at Jerusalem, and throughout all the coast of Judea, and then to the Gentiles, that they should be fed, turn to God, and to the Word, pity of repentance. And to your spirit, hallelujah, the first soul, remember thy congregation, and thou and precious the whole.
Name the door. Christ is risen.
Jesus is risen.
Christos.
Voistiva voskres.
Christos anesti.
Alitos anesti.
You know, we're in the middle of the feast, and we're celebrating the reality that God loves us so much, and that He has identified with us so much that we have Him in our lives and in our presence because of His accomplishment for us. So as we continue to celebrate our Lord's death and resurrection, and we also have a feast today of St. Constantine and Helen, and they are called evil to the apostles. Because in reality, in truth, they help the Orthodox Church to transition from an illegal and persecuted church to one that was to become the faith of the empire, the Byzantine Empire. And their love for Christ and His church abounded in the building of churches and doing charitable works. Because at the moment they took the cross at all four corners, so everywhere we look, we saw the cross of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and know that we were sealed by that cross and we were given life by that cross. And these readings, Carolian readings for this feast of St. Constantine and Helen, the second Carolian reading is from Isaiah chapter 61. And verse 10 says the following. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My soul shall be joyful in my God, for He has clothed me with the garment of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness. As a bridegroom decks himself with ornaments, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. The bishop, priest, deacon, all say this prayer as they put on their baptismal garment, whether it's the sacrament, the sacrari, or the white baptismal robe that the priest wears. This reality for us that we, through all of Lent and through all of this Paschal season, are renewing our baptism. We are rededicating ourselves to Christ for our life. And this is essential for us to do. The church gives us this opportunity to take what the church has given to us and to rejoice in that, to be clothed in Christ. The Matins Gospel for this feast day is from John chapter 10, 9 through 16. And in that gospel, there are three verses in it where our Lord begins with the words, I am. I am. And the first one is in verse 9. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. The door for us again is baptism. If nothing happens to us in the church, it can happen to us. Without baptism. Even some of the martyrs were baptized by fire, but they still had that entrance, that beginning of their life in Christ through baptism. And we put on Christ. We entered into His death and resurrection. Psalm 22 in the Septuagint, verses 1 and 2, says the following, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. What is this green pasture that the psalmist is talking about? It's not the kingdom of God. He's talking about life in God. He is the giver of life. I came that they may have life. John 10:10 continues. I came that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly. Our Lord's word is the giver of life. It gives us life. That's why it's so essential for us to participate in listening to the scriptures, not only on the Lord's Day, not only on the feast day, but every day of our life. To be fed and nurtured by His Word. His Word, Christ is the bridegroom, and all of us are the bride. I don't think oftentimes we realize this, that not only is this a baptismal garment, it's also a wedding garment. It's also the fact that we become the bride of Christ, that all of us are wedded to Him through the sacraments and through the life of the church. The second I am of this gospel is in John 10:11. It says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. So, in the process of Deacon Paul becoming ordained to the Holy Priesthood, during the great entrance, he's going to come out, not with the air on his shoulder as he normally would. He will come out with the air over his head. And that symbolism of that air over his head is that his life from now on is hidden in Christ. His coming priesthood that he's going to be ordained to is hidden in Christ. And that air will again be upon his face and my face and all those who are ordained to priesthood when we revoke. When we are sung away by the church, again our face is covered with that same air. Because it's not our personality that is important. It's how we fulfill our life in Christ. When we see the priest, we should in a very way see Christ's presence with us. He blesses us with his hands in the form of Jesus Christos, Jesus Christ. He's central for us in our understanding of our life, our Orthodox life. The third I am in this gospel is in John 10:14. He says, I am the shepherd. And I know my sheep, and I know by my own. During the laying of the hands, the bishop is going to say the following prayer from Deacon Paul. Do thou, the same Lord of all, deign to preserve the pureness of life, in an unswerving faith, this man also, upon whom through me thou hast graciously to lay thy hand. Even the bishop is an instrument of God's presence in this ordination. It's through Christ that Paul is raised to the ranks of the Holy Spirit. Be favorable, please, to grant unto him the great grace of the Holy Spirit, and to make him holy, thy servant, in all things acceptable unto you, and worthily exercising the great honors of the priesthood, thou hast conferred upon him by thy prescient powers. God is with us. He's always present. But how many times, O Lord, did you say Christ is in us? And we hear peace be in him. All these indications are for us to understand that Christ is here with us constantly through our prayers and through our life. And it is a wonderful prayer. It is also said the consecration begins at the moment of taking things. And it says, God created me a clean heart, put a new and right spirit within me. That prayer, that offering of ourselves to be vessels of God, to be endued with the Holy Spirit, alive in Christ and alive in God through that Holy Spirit, action in our lives, is what we're also anticipating and celebrating through this event. It was done for us at the time of our ordination. We were anointed from the top of our head to our feet, immersing ourselves in the gift of the Holy Spirit. Essential words. And then the following prayer that is said, usually by the deacon or by the priest or president, cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. We should always be preparing ourselves to be those receptacles of the Holy Spirit, to be open, to be sort of, as we see that they focus in the book of God in the prayer, just to look back to the icon right over the doors, and to let it there by showing their hands operate, and being receptive. Open. Deacon Paul has been in this community, prayed, served, worked, teaching, being a full part of the church here. Now he's been raised up to the diaconate. In this liturgy today, our liturgy, he's going to be raised up to the priesthood. Your pastor, teacher, director, guiding you along the center line of the church that leads towards the kingdom of God, which is represented by the altar. Your cooperation with me is essential. His goal is to make you to the fullness of the stature of fullness. That's an awesome responsibility that he has. He needs your prayer. He needs your support. He needs your love. He needs your understanding. He needs you to be present with him. So that it's not just one or two gathering together, but the community gathers together to offer themselves in Christ to God. And the priest leading you higher and higher, closer to the Lord. You set that up as your goal, and you strive to accomplish that with it. It's like our life with Christ, our life with God. It's a synergy, it's a cooperation. God doesn't force us to do it. Future Father Paul is not going to force you to do this. He's going to instruct you. He's going to try to teach you. You have to follow this voice, which is actually
your mom here, no sitting.
He gets to bring you closer and closer to you. Heaven. My soul is enlightened by the light of heaven. At times like these, we see everything clearly. We assess everything rightly. We feel friendly and loving towards everyone, even our enemies, whom we freely forgive. How blessed is the soul that is at one with God. The church can be, it should be, and I know through the ministry of Deacon Paul, will be a heavenly place to worship God and to praise Him. He has been prepared his whole life, his mentor and teacher from the very beginning of his life was the late fighter arsonist John Fairbank, who, again, I know visited Chabot constantly at the time that Deacon Paul was young, again, nurturing him and directing him along the path of the church and to the fullness of the life of the church. How many of us, of all of us, have a chapel in our life? A chapel. That's how Deacon Paul grew up with a chapel in his home. The love that was engendered in him to Father John and to the community around him, it was always there. You know, his love and dedication to the church, and his knowledge of the church and its order. You know, what did he do about Father John? So he had no choice but to follow things, to make things to be in good order and beauty and love. And this was instilled in Paul. Now, when I came to Paramus as a rector in 2003, you didn't have to really do anything as a priest. Paul had everything in order before the services, he had everything in order after the services. He was probably the first one there, and he was the last one to leave. And that sort of really in his heart to love the church in that way. He remained humble. He remained humble. Even after, you know, receiving the doctorate, you know, this sort of real sacrifice that he made to attain such a degree, he still had this humility and wonderful love, which I pray and I hope and I know that he will retain, that he will share that with you. And please follow his example. So may God bless Deacon Paul, his family, his God-given flock, and may his light shine upon you, and may he give all of you peace. Christ is risen.
Indeed he is risen.
Christ is risen.
Alleluia Sanesti.
Lord have mercy.
Oh,
King of all who come. Axios.
Axios, Axios, Axios.
Axios.
Axios, Axios, Axios.
Axios. Axios.
Axios, Axios, Axios.
Thank you.
begotten, begotten of the Father before all ages. Light of light to God, of true God, begotten, not made, of righteousness with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried. And the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets, in the Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us stand, O rise, let us stand with fear, let us attend as we are the Holy
Holy. And with your spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray.
Amen.
Paradise, a Pascha which sanctifies all the faithful. vanish his soul, let them vanish. Out from that sea, O women bearers of the tidings, and say to Zion, receive from us the glad tidings of joy, of Christ's resurrection. Exalt and be glad, and rejoice, O Jerusalem, seeing Christ the King who comes forth from the tomb, like a bridegroom in procession. So the sinners will perish before the face of God, but let the righteous be glad. The murmuring women at the break of dawn drew near to the tomb of the life-giver. There they found an angel sitting upon the stone. He greeted them with these words, why do you seek the living among the dead? Why do you mourn the incorruptible corruption? Go, proclaim the glad tidings to his disciples. This is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Us of beauty, the Pascha of the Lord, the Pascha worthy of all honor has done for us. Pascha, let us embrace each other joyously. Us a ransom from affliction, for today is from a bridal chamber. Christ has shone forth from the tomb, and filled the women with joy, saying, proclaim the glad tidings to the apostles. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. This is the day of resurrection. Let us be illumined by the feast. Let us embrace each other. Let us all brothers, even those that hate us, and forgive all by the resurrection. And so let us cry, Christ is risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and upon those in the tombs bestowing life.
That's 28. Actually, that's 28. That's 28. Right now, that's 28.
In the fear of God, faith and love, draw near.
Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. God is the Lord and has revealed himself to us.
I believe, O Lord, and I confess that thou art truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am first. I believe also that this is truly thine own most pure body, and this is truly thine own precious blood. Therefore I pray thee, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, of word and of deed, committed in knowledge or in ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy most pure mysteries, for the remission of my sins, and unto life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystical supper, O Son of God, accept me today as a communicant, for I will not speak of thy mysteries to thine enemies. Neither like Judas will I give thee a kiss, but like the thief will I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. In the communion of thy holy mysteries, be neither to my judgment, nor unto my condemnation, O Lord, but to the healing of souls and bodies.
Body and blood of our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ, the remission of his sins and to life everlasting.
Oh.
Trampling on death by death, and upon those in
Thank you.
Oh. Yep.
Please come to one of
sentis primas disolim, aris amen.